Hello guys, welcome back. In the last class we have seen about data types. In today's class we'll be seeing about constants, variables and expressions. This is a very basic programming that we are going to learn today. Constants. So as you are already aware, constants are nothing but fixed values which are not going to change during your program execution. Constants can be broadly classified into two categories: numbers and characters. Okay, again, these numeric constants can be subdivided into integer constants, real constants, complex constants. And then we have character constants, again existing as single character constants, string constants and escape sequence constants. So let us see into each of these constants now in the actual MATLAB scenario. Let us open MATLAB. So first we have integer constants. So integer constants are any integers. It can be a negative integer or a positive integer. Like you can have 456 or minus 456, or you may have 1500, but you cannot have 25.43 called as a integer, because these come under real numbers. I hope you know the basic difference between integers and real numbers, right? Again, we cannot have commas or full stop within a number. Okay, if you write 15100 as 1,500, it cannot be a single integer. So never use dots or commas while writing a integer in MATLAB. Next is real numbers. Real numbers can be any floating number. So real numbers include integers, but they are much more higher in range, that they can include floating point numbers also. So you can have a 0.52, or you may have 65.34, something like that. And then you can express the real numbers in another way, the exponential notation. That is, you may express, let us say 65.345 is there. You can also express it as 6.534E2. So if I write 6.534 into E2, what you got? 653.4. Now if you want 65.345, then you may have to write 6.534 E1. Okay, similar like. Okay, in MATLAB, E means 10 to the power of. It is not your 2 point something, it is your 10 to the power of something. Say, I can tell it as 10 power x. E power x is equal to 10 power x. Within the MATLAB environment. Next we have complex numbers, so or complex constants. So MATLAB recognizes either your I or J as complex numbers. They are predefined. So if I hit I and hit enter, it will show answer as 0 plus 1 i, where I is nothing but your root over minus 1. Similarly, not only I, MATLAB even recognizes J as a complex number root over minus 1. So as long as you are not using I and J as a different variable, by default, MATLAB recognizes I and J as root over minus 1. Now let us consider a complex number Z is equal to minus 6 plus 8i. So instead of writing 8i, I have to write 8 into i. You may also write like that. But you cannot write minus z as minus 6 plus i8. You cannot write like this. It will record, it's shown as unrecognized function or variable. Okay. So I may write it as minus 6 plus 8. Okay. So z is minus 6 plus 8. Now if I want to extract the real number or the real part within this complex number, then I can use the function. Okay, I want to get z real value. So I can use a function called real. It's an inbuilt function, real of z. So real of z is your minus 6. Similarly, if I want to get imaginary component or the imaginary part of your complex number, z imaginary part, I want to get, you can use the function imag, image of z. Now if I want to get the magnitude of this complex number, so I want to get the magnitude of this complex number, then I can use the inbuilt function ABS, so which stands for absolute value. Okay, so what's absolute value that we are getting? Mag z equal to 10, that is root over 6 square minus 6 square plus 8 square. Also, you may use the inbuilt function square root also in order to get this magnitude. So you may use this law that you already know that here a complex number into its conjugate is equal to magnitude square, right? So if you want to get the magnitude, you may use square root of complex number into complex conjugate. So for conjugate, you have a function conj. Of course, it makes it more difficult to write this expression. However, just for our practice and to introduce this inbuilt function called conjugate, I'm using this statement. So even if you are using the square root of z into conjugate of z, then also you are getting the same value. Next, you may want to get the argument or your angle of your complex number. If you want to get the angle of your complex number, then you may use angle of z equal to angle of, here you need to remember that this angle is by default is in radians, it is not in degrees. In case you want to get the value in degrees, then you have to use a function, inbuilt function, rad 2 degrees of z. So it is 126.8699 degrees. Again, if you want to convert it back to radians, you may have to use degree to radian, DEG to RAD of, here your answer. Again, you are getting 2.2143 radians. So let us go back to the conversions now. So if you want to convert this complex number which is in the Cartesian value, if you want to convert into polar value, so what are the Cartesian values? Let us see first. So we have z real, right? So z real is minus 6. Similarly, z image, imaginary number component is 8. Now if you want to get this in the polar coordinates, then you can write this function theta comma r equal to Cartesian to polar of your real component. What's your real component? Z real. Come on, what is your imaginary component? Z img. Now you are getting the angle theta as 2.2143 and the magnitude is again shown as 10. So again this theta is in radians. So you may use any other variable in this place, but only thing you need to know is that the first variable is your angle, the second variable is your magnitude. Similarly, you may want to again convert this into Cartesian values. For example, I want to convert into some x and y, where x is your real part of your complex number, y is your imaginary part of your complex number. Then I will be using polar to cart, POL to CART of, again, the first variable should be your theta. Second variable should be your magnitude r. I'm getting x is equal to minus 6 and y is equal to 8, which are nothing but our real and imaginary parts of our complex number z. Now we shall move back to the character constants. So character constants are again of three subcategories, which are single character constants, string constants, and escape constants. So let us see what is a single character constant. So a single character constant can be any letter like your A, B, C, D, and so on. So I may create in MATLAB a single character constant, let us say A. So this is a single character constant. You may also use this underscore. So all these are single character constants. Now string constant. So string is nothing but an array of your characters, right? Now you can have strings like good, bad, or I may have a combination of characters like g1. So this is a string. So if you have any doubt, you can refer to the workspace. In workspace is showing 1/2 char, right? Next we'll be seeing the escape sequence constants. So escape sequence constants are nothing but which are used in output functions who has to either go for a new line or to be used as a tab or to go for a backspace. So this escape sequence constants are backslash b. I'll go back, backslash b. This is used to mean backspace. And then we have backslash t to mean tab. And then backslash n, it means a new line. This we will be going to use when we are dealing with input and output statements. As of now, only thing you need to remember is that these are escape sequence constants. Do not worry much about them. We'll be using them, at least if not backslash b, at least we'll be using backslash n or backslash t on a regular basis when we are dealing with input and output statements. Next, we'll be going back to our presentation. Next is variable. So we have dealt with constants. Now we are moving to the variables. So variables means that they are varying with the along with the program. See, at the starting of the program, they may have a different value, and by the end of the program, they may end up with a different value. So they will undergo a change as per the lines of code that you have written. So the only advantage of MATLAB compared to others is that, like if you have a C language, if you want to declare a variable, so you'll be declaring a variable like int I is equal to 1 at the very beginning of your program. You have to declare all your variables at the very start of your program. Whereas in MATLAB, you need not declare separately in advance. So you may declare the variables at any point of time, at any point of your program. Okay, but so while using any variable in MATLAB, you need to remember these points. The variable name may consist of any alphabet as the first character, followed by either alphabets or numerals or underscore. So you should not start your variable name with any numeral or underscore. So I can have, so I'll go back to the MATLAB to discuss this point. I can have a variable name a underscore 1 is equal to 5, but I cannot have underscore a equal to 2, invalid text character. So the first character of your variable cannot be a number or special characters like underscore. Okay, the length of your variable name may have a maximum 131 characters. Beyond this limit, even if you are writing any extra characters as a variable name, they will be ignored. All the extra characters will be ignored. But I hope that none of us will write a lengthy variable name beyond 131 characters. For our day-to-day programming, always we'll be using a short variable name. That too, it's always advisable to use meaningful names. Okay, we cannot randomly give a variable name, because the variables are conveying some information, right? So on seeing the variable name itself, we should be able to understand why we are using that variable. So always it is advisable to use meaningful names for variables. And usually we'll be using lowercase letters. It's not mandatory, but usually we will not go for uppercase letters. So there's nothing wrong even if you are using uppercase letters also. But normally, usually programmers use lowercase letters. We cannot have multiple words in as a variable name. You cannot have, for example, my name is Sharat Chandra. I cannot have Sharat space Chandra as a variable name. Blank spaces cannot be included in MATLAB variable names. Instead, if you want to write Sharat Chandra as a variable name, I'll be using Sharat underscore Chandra. Okay. So for example, I'm again going back to the MATLAB. I cannot use unrecognized function or variable. Instead, I may use Sharat underscore Chandra equal 1. So the first variable name is not accepted because we have a blank space. Second variable name is accepted because you have underscore. Okay, so when you want to include multiple words in the variable name, then you have to use this underscore for connectivity. And case sensitive. So already I have told you many times that MATLAB is case sensitive. So if you are having two variable names with uppercase letters GOLD and lowercase letters GULD, both are two different variables. They can have different types of data. They can have different values. And then you cannot have keywords as variable names. So keywords are nothing but some reserved words are there within MATLAB so that MATLAB can function properly. Okay, for example, you have a while, switch, for, if function. These are all reserved words for MATLAB. That's used for some inbuilt functions. Okay, or for some structure of your MATLAB, these are codes that are used. These reserved words cannot be used as variable names. Let us see what happens if I'm using such reserved words. If I use if equal to 1. So it is showing that incorrect use of, because it is thinking that I'm comparing something, because usually if is a comparative statement. It's a conditional statement. So it is thinking like that. So I cannot use while is equal to 4. Similarly, I cannot use function is equal to 2. So this kind of variables you cannot use in MATLAB. Always it is advisable never to use these reserved words either as variables or as file names or as function name. It will be very difficult because even in your class, if you have two Ravis in your class, when somebody calls Ravi, so people will be confused whether you are calling Ravi 1 or Ravi 2, right? Similarly, when these reserved words or use as function names or file names, the MATLAB will be confused. Okay. It may also, there's a fair chance of getting an error. So blindly, you go with this rule that never use reserved words either as variable names or as functions names or as file names. Next, proceeding with our PPT. Next, we have special constants and variables. So why this name special? What's the special? The specialty is nothing that they're already included. These variables are already, or constants are already declared in MATLAB. So you need not declare this value. For example, you have pi. So I need not define what pi value is in MATLAB. So if I write simply pi, it is showing that pi is 3.1416. So you may directly use pi as a value in your computations in MATLAB. Similarly, as I already told you, I is your imaginary number. Similarly, J is your imaginary number. They are pre-declared in MATLAB. Next, we'll be seeing INF. So, INF means that it's an infinite. NaN means that it's not a number. EPS means small number equivalent to zero. So, it is more or less like your precision. How much close it is zero to zero, it will be showing. ANS is your default output variable, like in your calculator. Nargin. So, Nargin is a inbuilt variable which is used to specify the arguments of a function. So, what's a function? What are arguments? We shall see at a later point of stage. So, it will calculate how many number of arguments are given to a function. Similarly, nargout will give the number of output arguments of a function. So, realmax will give the largest real number that can be displayed in the MATLAB. Okay, let us see further details if you want to see. So, MATLAB represents the values that are not real or complex numbers with a special value called NaN. So, which is stands for not a number. So, if I have some computation where I am doing 0 by 0. So, it is showing NaN. So, NaN stands for not a number. I may also do 5 by 0. If I do 5 by 0, I am getting INF, which stands for infinite. And then we have EPS. EPS refers to precision of floating numbers. So for a double type of number, you have a different EPS. And then for a single type, you have a different EPS. So let us see what is EPS in MATLAB. If I write EPS, is showing some value 2.2 into 10 power minus 16. So always read E as 10 power. Okay. So if I write if I go for help EPS. All I told you that help is an inbuilt function. So here you can see that if you are using EPS for different types of numbers, you are getting different values. So if I am using for single value, so EPS of single of 0, I should get 2 power minus 149. So whose value is 1.401? 3 into 10 power minus 45. So it specifies the precision of your floating point number. Nargin returns the number of function input arguments to the currently executing function. So this Nargin or Nargout can be used only within the definition of function. So when you are using a function definition, within the function body, you can use this Nargin variable. You cannot use this Nargin variable wherever you like. And then realmax. So realmax is the largest finite floating point number. Now we shall see what's a realmax in our MATLAB in my scenario. So realmax that I can handle is 1.7977 into 10 power 308. That's the largest real number that I can have. We shall discuss the continuation of constants, variables and expressions in the next video, in which we are going to deal about operators. So we'll be discussing about arithmetic operators, relational operators, logical operators, hierarchy of operations and some sample programs we shall see. Thank you.